What's up, guys? It's Mark. Now, I've teamed up with MSI and CCL Computers for a two-part series. In the first episode, we'll be taking a look at some high-end MSI components that will give you a great experience in two up-and-coming AAA games, Blackout and Battlefield 5. Both games are a ton of fun, and I never thought I'd say that about a Call of Duty game ever again. CCL are a very popular online PC store that sell individual components and fully built custom gaming PCs. And I personally recommend building your own. That said, if you're new to PC gaming and don't want the hassle, they have some great options. Checking out the build, overall I'm very impressed, especially with the cable management. In the past, I've had a few pre-built PCs sent from other companies, and cable management sometimes has been a little sloppy. Not here though, they've even used zip ties on the tubing from the H100i Pro, so it doesn't cover up that beautiful DDR4. The PC is currently priced at, wait for it, £1,992.99. As I said earlier, you could reduce the price by switching out some of the components. Running through all of the parts, the PC has Intel's i7-8700K. With some tweaking in the BIOS, you will hopefully be able to run this CPU near 5GHz without too much trouble. Corsair's H100i Pro, an all-in-one liquid cooler, will definitely help you achieve the best possible overclock. I should know because I use one in all of my PCs. Corsair Vengeance RGB Pro DDR4 comes as standard in this build, so you could save a lot of money if RGB isn't for you. Clocked at 3000 MHz, it will be more than enough for even 4K editing in Premiere Pro. In fact, I would be more than happy to edit my own videos with this PC. That said, honestly, it would be a shame to buy this PC without Vengeance Pro DDR4, probably the best looking RAM on the market right now. The motherboard is MSI's Z370 Gaming Plus Edition, an unusual choice for this build considering the other components, as it's not one of MSI's high-end boards. For instance, there's no I/O cover or RGB lighting, but I guess it keeps the overall cost of the build down. The storage inside this PC is awesome. Not only is there a 4TB Seagate Barracuda 3.5-inch hard drive, but a 500GB Samsung M.2 solid-state drive running the OS. Windows will be blazing fast, as well as any games you install on the drive. For graphics, you can switch and change to your heart's desire. My version has a GTX 1080 Gaming X Edition from MSI. Gaming on the MSI MPG27CQ, a 2560x1440 144Hz monitor with this card, is a mind-blowing experience. I'm able to put my in-game settings at high and ultra and still take full advantage of the 144Hz panel, since the GPU manages to still throw out so many frames at the monitor. Once you go 144Hz, you never go back. With the latest games like Battlefield 5 and Black Ops 4 coming out, you may want to consider upping to a 1080 Ti, as in my opinion, that's the perfect 1440p resolution, high FPS card, although a 1080 will still deliver a great experience. Taking a look at the case, I was offered to review this a while ago but turned it down because I was extremely busy. Now, what a mistake that was. Now I've seen it in person, Corsair are absolutely killing it lately. The carbide spec Omega RGB is ridiculous, in a good way. The two-tone effect of black and white is right up my street in terms of design. It looks like some sort of sculpture. The front has an LED light that I didn't realise syncs up with other RGB Corsair components, and it shows up even in the Commander Pro software, and I nearly flipped my lid when I saw this. It's sick. Paired with a transparent front that exposes the HD120 fans, it really looks the part on any desk. Front airflow is a bit of a concern, since it only draws cold air from the bottom of the case. The build overall would have had a much better airflow if the radiator was moved to the top, paired with another two HD120 RGB fans. And just to note, this build doesn't come with any RGB LED strips, Corsair or otherwise. Finishing off the ultimate MSI gaming setup, you will need the MSI G27CQ. I know that doesn't stand for miles per gallon. I did a mini review of this monitor talking about how it's a great, far cheaper alternative to the crazy 4K 144Hz monitors that are out at the moment. I'll link my previous video I did in the description of the MSI monitor. Highly recommend it considering it's £450 or US dollars and it has RGB lighting. Rounding off now, you aren't going to get very far as the ultimate MSI fanboy without these. The Clutch GM70 gaming mouse, the GK80 mechanical keyboard, and MSI's Immerse GH70 gaming headset. All of them have crazy RGB lighting that can be customized in the Mystic Light software, and they are very well built products, and it depends on your own personal taste, of course, whether you like the styling. I don't particularly like the headset, but each to their own, although it sounds good. So that's part one of two. In the second video coming up, I'll be checking out a more budget-friendly setup geared towards games like Fortnite, so I'll be sure to clickbait the title in that video. Anyway, guys and girls, I really hope you've enjoyed me ranting on and showcasing some of the best products from MSI available from CCL Computers. My name's Marcia from Silence of the Lambs. Goodbye. Wait, what?